And I know everybody. I mean, everyone knows each other by sight, and we look out for each other. And it's, I mean, during Hurricane Sandy hit New York, I mean, a lot of the people that had young children had to leave because there was no light, there was no water, the power was out, right? Half of Manhattan was completely dark. And it was really actually quite dangerous at night in the dark half of Manhattan, and where there was no streetlights. And so this building, it's a tenement building that I live in with my wife, and a lot of the people left, and they were worried about being robbed. And these are poor people, right? This is not a wealthy building at all. It's quite a poor building. And so they organized a guard shift. One of the women in the building had a machete, and they organized guard shifts at the front door with a machete. And the young men in the building took turns, like 2 hours at a time, guarding the building with a machete.
Whoa.
Yeah. And, you know, I wasn't associated with the building at that time, but boy, would that have made me feel good to be part of that. Like that, you know what I mean? Like that is what human beings, that's what they are.
Right.
It's that. Right. And you didn't see that in a wealthy neighborhood, partly because the wealthy neighborhoods actually had light.
Right. It just seems weird to make the choice to live in a community like that because of those factors.
Well, my wife lived there and I moved in with her. So, the reason I was happy to move in with her, one of the reasons I was happy to move in with her is precisely because it wasn't an affluent neighborhood like the kind I grew up in. That to me is just soul death, right? I mean, it's just, I grew up in an affluent suburb, and it's just the most boring thing on the planet. Like, it's just deadly to me. And I, you know, like, had I not grown up like that, maybe I'd be living in a neighborhood like that. I mean, I get it, right? But I did grow up like that. And the one thing that I just cannot survive is that kind of complacent affluence. Like, it just kills me.
It's so funny because that's the one thing that people try to achieve when they grow up in that sort of poor community. They want to get out and live in that big house with a big yard.
Look at their suicide rates, their addiction rates, their depression rates. I mean, seriously, if you look at those, alcoholism, depression, suicide in affluent neighborhoods, I mean, it's astronomical. It's brutal.
Boy.